Hey everyone, Marianne here with Microsoft, and I have a question for you. What is your favorite go-to feature of Microsoft 365? If that took you longer than 5 seconds to come up with, then I have some great tips for you. But before we get into talking about these tips, let's take a moment to discuss which devices need Microsoft 365, and the answer to that is pretty simple. You can tell everyone that every device needs Microsoft 365. Now, you may be asking yourself, every device, really? And the answer is yes, every device. Having Microsoft 365 on a Windows PC is a pretty obvious solution, but you can also have Microsoft 365 with a Mac or a Chromebook, an iPad or an Android tablet, an iPhone or Android phone, even an Apple Watch or other smart devices. Just about every device you see in stores could tie back to Microsoft 365. Even some refrigerator come with tablets now, and even if they don't, everyone needs to make a grocery list. Because no matter what device you use, everyone needs to get stuff done, and Microsoft 365 helps every person to achieve more in less time. Alright, so we've re-established that every device needs Microsoft 365 now. You've probably watched some of our videos and you probably already have an ID. So you see an awesome feature, and whether you're a seasoned veteran or new to Microsoft 365, this feature will be something you'll find extremely helpful on or off the job. It's the Microsoft Search feature. It works great on any device in any Microsoft 365 application. If you're not sure how to do something or where a function is, just ask and you'll find the answer. Search is great because it just does it for you. No added steps. This is one simple way you can attest how Microsoft 365 takes the work out of the work. Okay, let's jump into Microsoft 365 and see how Microsoft Search works. One of my favorite ways to use this feature is how easily I can adjust the margins with it. We've all probably had to adjust the margins once or twice before, but it's not something that we do every day, so it can be difficult to remember where the margin setting is. So just click on Search and type in Margin. The Margins option will show up and you can easily adjust them. This even works if you're not 100% sure what you want to do. For example, I want to put the big confidential word across my document and, oh, that's right, it's called watermark. So now I get all the watermark options I can put in my document. Microsoft Search is like your virtual productivity assistant that allows you to spend less time finding how to adjust margins and more time being productive with your time. So be sure to try the search feature. Next, let's talk about OneDrive. Microsoft 365 is great with OneDrive for three specific reasons. First, you can access your files from any device. You can use your phone, tablet, or computer to continue what you started wherever you happen to be. Any changes you make will be updated on all of your devices. Second is you get offline access. Stay productive when you're off the grid. You can access your files without being online, which means you can always have your most important files with you. And third, it keeps your files safe if something happens to your device. You don't have to worry about losing your files or photos. They're in your OneDrive, and OneDrive is encrypted using SSL, or Secure Sockets Layer, a super fancy way of saying your stuff is safe. With Microsoft 365, up to 6 people can have each their own 1 TB of OneDrive cloud storage. The value of Microsoft 365 is simple math. Microsoft 365 equals OneDrive plus so much more. You get 1 TB of storage space plus all the Microsoft 365 apps like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, plus even more additional apps and services, such as our newest feature, Microsoft Defender, for one low monthly price. So just remember that every device needs Microsoft 365. Phone, tablets, PC, or Mac, all devices can and should always come with Microsoft 365. Hopefully, this gave you some tools that you can use in your next task. Microsoft 365 has a lot of great features and lots to talk about, but sometimes it can be confusing to know where to start. But with more tips like today, you can grow more confident in your use of Microsoft 365. I'm Marianne, and see you next time. Bye!